you really represent sort of the best of Virginia and the best of kind of the American innovation economy. I'm really glad to be here with Mark Warner. Mark and I, as you mentioned, we've known each other since law school, and I had the wonderful opportunity to serve as his lieutenant governor and watch him do a number of things that were tough, that were forward-focused, and that then helped me when I became governor and then had to be governor in the worst recession since the 1930s. I had had a chance to really learn from a great governor, and it helped me get through some challenging times. And one other thing about Mark, you know, he didn't give you the full PowerPoint. Mark is working on the one bipartisan thing that's happening in our entire Congress right now that really has some promise, which is this gang of six in the Senate, three Democrats, three Republicans, and about 25 or 30 allies who are helping them, who are not only trying to solve our budget problems, but are trying to revive traditions of the parties working with each other. We can be proud Democrats, Republicans, independents, but ideas just sit on shelves with dust on them if people are not willing to find compromise and make something happen and implement it. And Mark and his colleagues are really playing a key role in trying to make the Senate do that again. It's been what the Senate has been able to do in the past, but we're gridlocked now. And so, Mark, thank you for your great leadership, and thanks for your friendship and being here. I've loved public service. I've been in office for about 16 years as a city councilman, mayor in Richmond, lieutenant governor, and governor. This is a tough time right now, and yet visits like that we've had today, we've done three visits with companies in Norfolk, Richmond, Fredericksburg, and now here, you know, convince us that the tough is a leadership challenge, and it's frankly a congressional leadership that isn't kind of acting at the same level as we see out in our private economy, out in the communities where Virginians and Americans live and work. We have such resources, we have such creativity, we have such powerful ideas, we just need to have a government that is sort of equal to what we see like here at Aurora. And John, you should feel very proud of what you're doing and what your team has accomplished. But you also give us some inspiration to make sure that we have a government that matches that and that allows it to thrive. I was a governor for 4 years. As you know, the Virginia governorship is unique in two ways in the United States. It's the only governorship that is a single four-year term. You can't run for re-election. It's also the only governorship where the title is Your Excellency. So, that, you know, that's not bad. I think they felt like 8 years of Your Excellency would not be good. So just one term. You just get one. I was governor in the worst recession since the 1930s. I'm the only governor in modern times that left office with a smaller budget, general fund budget, than when I started. Had to make a lot of painful cuts. Cuts of the kind that we're going to have to make to do what Senator Warner is trying to do to help us be about more fiscal responsibility. But I definitely learned in making a lot of cuts that you can't cut your way to prosperity. And if you're only cutting, if you're a family, if you're a business, if you're a government, and you're only cutting, you're making a big mistake. You've got to be making investments. You've got to be doing R&D. And my particular passion, and this is what I'd really like to focus on in the Senate, is you've got to be winning the talent race. I mean, this is a business that's about hardware and software, but fundamentally it's a business that's about talent. Talented people, innovative people, thinking of new strategies, tackling new challenges. When we win the talent race as an economy, we win the economic race globally, and we find it an easier path to solve our non-economic challenges too. So I want to go into the Senate and really work on issues like, you know, education, pre-K to post-grad, workforce development, R&D. We'll work on immigration reform, because I think immigration reform should be organized fundamentally around we want to be the most talented place on earth and have an immigration system that would allow us to do that. The last